Hello and welcome to the programme. So, on November the 21st, the ISO Lazio Cultural Platform presented an exhibition called Remont. It's a site-specific installation by renowned Tunis-born artist of Ukrainian origin, Nadia Karbulinkin. And I'm pleased to say, joining us right now is Nadia. Thank you so much for joining us in the studio.
Hello, thank you for inviting me.
So, I want to start with one of the quotes that we found that you gave relatively recently. It's, Remont is the Ukrainian expression for repair with the nuance that it became a paradox indicator for a closed circle of open-ended maintenance. And at that time I was thinking, what is that? It means if things break, they get fixed by breaking other things that get fixed and so on and so on. So can you tell us a bit more about your vision for this exhibition?
For the exhibition in general, let's come back to the idea of the remont, because, you know, being coming from here, my mom is originally from Kiev, and I somehow grew up also partly in Ukraine. So we had some kind of experiences of refurbishment of apartments in our family. And I realized that what you were saying, that also the structure in the city, when you see reparation in the street, for example, or institutional problems, you know, when we have problems, we repair them, but we repair them in a way that they create some other problems so that we still have to repair in a different way and so on. So I realized that the repair idea or refurbishment became like a kind of a lifestyle, and it had something to do with the Ukrainian mentality. And if you also look back at the history of the country or this part of the world, which just like it's a succession of crises and traumas, and people still never lost their lightness of being and the optimism, and I think it has a lot to do with this activity of ongoing reparation. So I felt like reparation or refurbishment is not just an action of doing something, it's really a way of being. And I wanted to translate this in a kind of an exhibition, because this is really my first exhibition in Ukraine.
Yes.
Even if I come very often here, but I never really had like a professional activity. It was more like a hometown, being with my family, and more a spiritual, like coming back place. So I wanted to have a work that was really linked and anchored to the country, to its this actual situation, but also, let's say, something very profoundly rooted in the city and the country. So that's why I thought that the remont is a kind of an interesting metaphor to dig into the Ukrainian mentality, let's say.
And how did you illustrate this remont in your particular exhibit? We saw a short video just then about sort of a little preview about the exhibit itself. But why did you choose the materials that you chose, and especially the layout as well? Everything's on the floor.
Yeah.
What is the significance of this?
First of all, it's not only on the floor. Actually, all the walls are filled and the floor is filled. But yet, when you come into the space, you feel that it's empty. So it is really an immersive installation. And I chose to work with the cobblestone, so it's the pavement that you see in the streets, for many reasons. First of all, because the streets, I mean, if you really are acquainted to the streets of Kiev or Ukraine in general, you really have to be very careful and look where you're putting your feet.
Yeah, especially in the winter.
But not only in the winter, because of the idea of the reparation that is ongoing. So everything is like a kind of moving state. And even if you take the car, it's like kind of shaky also. So the people who come into the exhibition, they also feel like it's a kind of a continuation between the public space, the outside and the inside, and I wanted to invert it. So I wanted to create a surrealist situation where when you come into the private space of the gallery, you would still find an element from the outside world, from the public space. So that was one of the things. And why I did that, because I think we live today, strangely enough, in a world that seems sometimes quite surrealist. When you just put on the radio or the TV, you hear things like, it's unbelievable. I don't want really to get into the examples. It's not only in Ukraine, but also in the world. So it's a succession of things where you think, okay, we have really touched the bottom and it's not possible that we can go any lower, and yet we still go lower. So I wanted to create also this kind of instability, first of all, because the floor is shaky. These cobblestones are not connected to each other in any way. They're just laying on the floor.
You can see people very carefully walking over
them.
Exactly.
It's really all shaky, and there is this, it's like also kind of a sound installation.
I guess the sound as well. Yeah, because
it plays an important role.
Well, if
as
you go
well.
To Isolatsi, it's also sometimes a very empty space as well. So I can imagine it echoes quite a lot when
the
you're
echo
walking.
Is, yeah, exactly. You feel the echo. So that's one aspect. But also, I was saying that the walls are filled, and what they're filled is really the distance between the stones. What should be holding the stones, the mortar that should be holding it, is not on the floor. It is on the wall. So I really wanted to separate the problem from the solution, in a way that we are looking at the solution. There we see how what we should do so that the floor should be stable, and we are not using the solutions. A bit, again, a metaphor to our everyday life. The solution becomes as if it's in the books. It's a theory, or let's say it's like a painting that we're looking at, but we don't have the courage really to take the right decisions in order to avoid the shaky situation in which we are. Yeah. So as if we prefer to walk on an unstable floor rather than taking the solution and putting it inside the connecting the two. So yeah, this exhibition is really a lot about our actual situation, but without a narration. It's just putting the spectator and the viewer in real, the physical and the aesthetical, the emotional feeling that we have actually when we leave the gallery space.
And I can imagine, I mean, in any artwork, the people who go to exhibitions like yours come away with different thoughts. They're not really told what to think, but actually the shaky stones, the echo, they bring their own meaning to this. And you have a strong connection to Kyiv. You spend your time half between Berlin and Kyiv. So what sort of an influence has the city, Kyiv itself, but also your family background had on your particular work?
I think huge, but still probably very unconscious, because these things you don't really think about how things have influenced me. Probably I will say the most striking influence is the idea of the separation, because I grew up between Tunisia, Ukraine, and also the Emirates partly. So every time I was in one place, I always had the feeling that I'm so far away from my roots and my people that I love and my country. So this idea of country started to dissolve, and the idea of identity as well. And I embraced slowly, because of the separation, the world and the universe. And I started to understand that my identity is more the people who I love, and it's something that fluctuates. It's not something really rigid. And probably that's why my work doesn't have to do with a particular specific region in the world. It is very local. I start local, but it ends universal. And also, like in this example of Rimont, I started with a Ukrainian specificity, but actually it can apply to any place in the world today.
Because you've had other exhibits around the world as well. It's your first in Ukraine, but can you tell us a bit more about your previous exhibits that you've had?
Well, I don't know. I have exhibited really almost in all the continents. Yeah. Maybe Australia. I wasn't there yet. But
one day.
Yeah, maybe one day. But yeah, what can I tell you? Every time my work adapts to the context in which I am. So often it is site-specific, not always, but very often. And maybe because of my biography, which is filled of immigration and crossing borders, I can understand people in different places, and I have an empathy for the situation, but especially for the situation of the immigrants, because it is the case of my personal story, if you want.
And also, I thought it was interesting in your artwork, this is what I took away from it, is that it's actually, in a way, borderless. And this is to do with immigration as well.
Yeah.
And more and more people put up particular borders, whether it's in politics, trade barriers, but also in society as well. And this is a very predominant topic among the Ukrainian diaspora as well, who perhaps want to come back to Ukraine now. So how has this idea of a more borderless world affected your work? How do you show this?
Well, let's say that a borderless world is an ideal that doesn't exist, as you say. But maybe I am the embodiment of this borderlessness, because I would never be able to cut myself from my Arabic, African, Islamic influence and my Slav, European and Orthodox influence. And both are really strongly anchored in me. I think my parents did a good job to root me in both of my cultures. So when I come here, not even when I come, I feel very much rooted in the Slav and Orthodox culture, as I am, but also in the West, because I have been living more than half of my life in West Europe. My husband is German, my children are German, so I feel also somehow that the German culture is also part of mine today. I have adapted. I have lived before in France, where I finished my studies, so French culture is all. So you see, the borderlessness is more my way of being, but in the world in which we live, I am saddened to see that the walls are growing back.
Yeah, and in a way, that could, in a way, symbolize one brick because you have a lot of bricks in this exhibition on the floor as well. And perhaps you could see it as each one is a separate identity. And I don't know how many bricks you have at this particular exhibition, but each one
I can tell you that we have 32 tons of stones.
32
the weight.
Tons?
I know the weight.
Did you have to lay them all? I guess you had some help.
Of course. An amazing team in Isolazia. I mean, really, the support was incredible. Yeah.
And also, these stones really don't occupy a particular space as well. You just walk over them.
Yeah, is what I'm saying. It's as if it's empty, but it's filled. I mean, you cannot fill it more than that. From the weight and also from the whole floor is filled and the walls too. So it's like a total sculpture. And yet, when you come into the space, you feel more the emptiness.
Yeah. And for people who are perhaps visiting Kyiv or already here, how long is this exhibition going on for?
Until the 12th of January.
12th of January. Yeah. Okay, perfect. Well, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure to have you here.
The pleasure is mine. Thank you very
much. I wish
you
the best of luck with all your future projects.
Thank you very much.
That was Nadia Karbulinka. She is an artist who currently has the Remont project here in Kyiv. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more here on UATV.